are my feet.
Up here to break it out. Follow me, we'll get you free.
You.
I'm here to break you.
Hey,
let's go.
We'll be free.
Hey guys.
That'll heal.
Come with me
now. Come on, group, let's move it.
We'll be free.
Follow me to flame!
Oh,
Hey, Chub.
We've been expecting you, Abe. Let's go. Finally. You hear something?
I'm here to break
it. All right, then. Let's go. Free.
All right. Why not? too hot. Follow me.
Wait.
We're stopping.
Come on. I don't know why we're stopping. I don't know.
Everybody, let's get
the
out of here.
The fight never comes.
Ugh!
still in hiding. Following the disaster at Rupture Farms, Moloch the Glucken is still in hiding, avoiding having to answer for his shameful actions. The shamed CEO is being sought by the authorities, having fled shortly after the factory burned to the ground, killing everyone inside. Citizens are warned that he may be dangerous.
Here's something.
Just killed 300 Wadokans and an undetermined number of security guards that apparently failed along with his plan, and are asked to report any sightings.
You hear that? What up?
You show the way!
I'm here to get you free. Let's go!
Wait here.
Hey, why'd you hold up? I could go for a sandwich right now.
We gotta get out of here.
Come on,
let's get out of here.
Stop.
Follow me. We'll get you free.
Right.
Oh, did I do that?
Thank you.
beautiful friendship exist than that between the Mudokons and the Gluckens? The benevolent Gluckens who provide the Mudokons with food, shelter, and structure are repaid with gratitude, respect, and hard work. It's a perfect relationship, and nowhere was that relationship more perfect than at Rupture Farms. Trusting, kind, and gentle, the Mudokons worked alongside Sligs and livestock in harmony, bringing those treats we all know and love to our tables. Rupture Farms was a place of aspirations, happiness, and honesty, and the Mudokons would never dream of overthrowing their benevolent bosses. Or so we thought. As it turns out, this was the work of someone who should never have been trusted, someone who only cared for himself. This was Mullik and Mullik alone.
Ugh!